Hello everybody, Repens the Turtle here, showing you how to install or replace a hard drive with the new SSD in the HP 17T line of laptops. The laptops in this line come with two hard drive bays, and so I finally decided to take advantage of the second hard drive bay and install an SSD. Since installing it, I have seen significant improvements in the boot time of my laptop, as well as improvements in loading up of programs. Speed increases were to be expected with the SSD upgrade. Even though I'm showing how to install the SSD in the second hard drive bay of this particular line of laptops, an SSD in any machine follows the same protocol. You can either begin with physically installing the SSD in the laptop, such as I did in this video, or begin with formatting the SSD externally. In Samsung's included installation guide, they suggest using an external hard drive USB adapter, as many laptops only have one hard drive bay, but since I have two hard drive bays, an external adapter was necessary. After physically installing the hard drive, all I had to do was put in the included disk that Samsung provided with the SSD and follow the on-screen instructions with formatting and installing the new drive. And also, I had to change the boot priority so that my laptop would be booting off of the second hard drive now instead of the first hard drive. The SSD that I decided to use to upgrade my laptop with is a 250GB Samsung 850 Evo. This SSD packs top-of-the-line performance for a reasonable price, especially since I was able to purchase it on sale. This particular SSD has left such an impression on me with its boost in computer performance that I even bought a second one, this time the 500GB model, and used it to upgrade a 2012 MacBook Pro. The MacBook was running quite sluggishly, and the upgrade fixed all of the issues I was having with it. For the HP 17T line of laptops, the hard drive bays do not have any sort of standard SATA cable, as can be found in desktop computers or in Mac computers. If you find yourself in need of the special SATA connector and rubber rails that are made for this line of laptop, check out the Amazon link in the video description. That is where I got my cable and rubber rails, and they've been working without a hitch ever since. As far as I can tell, the only problems with the SATA connector and the rails is that they were an extremely tight fit. So be wary of that when performing the upgrade yourself. As always, thanks for watching, and travel on, my fellow turtles.